In this video, we'll try to understand one typical example on moment area method. Now, the cantilever beam is as shown over here, and it carries a point load of P acting in the upward direction at the free end, as well as a moment of 400 Newton meter acting in the anti-clockwise direction at point C. Now we have to find out the value of P so as to produce no deflection at point A. So if the deflection at this particular free end, that is this particular end, if it is to be zero, then what will be the magnitude of this point P that we have to find out. In other words, we can say that delta or TAB is equal to zero. Now let us first draw the moment diagram for each of these particular forces. So as shown over here, this upward acting force P will produce the clockwise moment about point P, and from P, that is from point A up to point P, the perpendicular distance is 2 plus 2, that is 4. So 4 into P will be the moment which will be acting over here. So that is shown over here. So the moment will be 0 at this point, and at point B it will be 4P. Now let us locate the centroid of this particular triangular section. We know that the centroid will act at a distance of 2 times base upon 3, and base of this particular triangle is nothing but 2 plus 2, that is 4. So it is 8 upon 3. So area is equal to 1 half base into height. So base is 4 and height is 4P. So area is 8P kilonewton meter square. Now let us consider this particular anticlockwise moment which is acting, and as it is acting in the anticlockwise direction, that moment will be negative. So the diagram that we have drawn, and that 400 Newton meter is remaining same throughout this particular C and B, because there is no load or moment that is acting between C and B. So 400 Newton meter, that is uniform, so we will get a rectangular distribution over here. So distance of this CG from point A will be equal to this 2 as it is, and the centroid of this rectangle will lie at the center, that is 2 upon 2, that is total distance will be 3 meter. So as you can see over here, this x2 bar that we have just now calculated is like this, this 2 meter plus half of this 2 meter, which is the base of this rectangle. So that is 2 by 2 that we have indicated over here. Similarly, area for this rectangle will be equal to base into height. So base is this particular base, that is 2 meter, and height is minus 400 Newton meter, that is the anticlockwise moment which is acting and which is uniform between point C and B. So using this, we can now apply the theorem of the moment area method. So 1 upon EI, area of bending moment diagram multiplied by x bar. So there are two areas, A1 X1 bar plus A2 X2 bar, that we will have to take into consideration. So area A1 is 8P and X1 bar is 8 upon 3. Area A2 is minus 800 and X2 bar is 3. This EI will get cross multiplied with 0 and will get cancelled out. 8 into 8, that is 64P upon 3, minus 800 into 3, that is 2400, that is equal to 0. Transfer this negative term on this side, so it will become positive. And now you can easily calculate the value of P. So 2400 into 3 divided by 64 will give you the value of P. So when the value of P is 112.5 Newton, we'll get no deflection or zero deflection at the free end A of the given particular cantilever P. So in this way, we can find out this value of P. Thank you very much for watching.